I use a software called Stellarium. It's actually a heliocentric globe-based software. I mean, it's meant to work in that model. But I've been messing around with it because I wanted to see how the seasons work in the flat Earth model. Again, doing the scientific method. I come up with a hypothesis. I'm trying to test it. I'm trying to, see it, how it works. And I messed around with it for probably 2 days until I figured out how I could depict what I was trying to see. And the conclusion, the way I did it was, because I was trying to deal with the issue of the long days, where the sun never really goes down in Antarctica. So I used the software. You can download the software for free. Set the location parameter to the zero meridian and 90 degrees south, or whatever it is, basically the South Pole in the software. And the stereographic, I think, was the mode you can choose for viewing. And with the way the software works, you can look north, south, east, west, or you can change it in various ways so you can actually see north and east at the same time, or even zoom out a little bit, see, And I figured out how to zoom out and then basically flip the whole thing up, like as if you could see north, south, east, west, every direction basically over you. And I'm like, okay, that's cool. And then I hit the play button, which would animate I set the clock to January 1, 2015, and just set the play button to start everything moving, to start the sun and moving. So basically it's moving overhead, but from your view looking up, it's coming this way. So it's counterclockwise. So, and I got the whole year played out in like an hour. And I brought in the software and I wanted to depict it superimposed over the flat Earth map. So I put the flat Earth map, and since it was moving counterclockwise looking up, I just flipped it so that it's like you're looking down. And all I did was put it on top, I just superimposed it over the flat Earth map, and it shows you the sun and moon going in this orbit over the circular Earth and extending its orbit and contracting its orbit. And what really fascinated me is the software. I didn't manipulate it at all. It actually depicted this. It showed as the sun was moving in its outer circle, its outer circuit, it sped up, which it would naturally have to do to maintain a 24-hour day the same time as when it's in the inner part of the circle, it's going slower. And so to prove that, I put January and June up at the same time, showing the widest path circuit as compared to the inner circuit, and how it's sped up over here and slowed down over here. And I'm going, wow, here's this heliocentric globe-based software actually proving, at least in theory anyway, the seasons on the flat Earth map. And of course, you're talking about the sizes of this and the distances of the sun and moon, and the flat Earth map is completely different. But the biblical model says that it's the sun and moon that are moving, not the Earth. It's like 60 some 67 scripture or something like that, describing the sun, moon, and stars moving, zero showing the Earth moving. So here, at least in my mind anyway, is some fairly convincing evidence, oddly enough, taken from heliocentric globe-based software.
As far as I'm concerned, the world could still be flat. Think for yourself. You have to be willing to cut against the grain and get the distance from your peer group.
When they said Earth was flat, what man searched for the truth?
We born not knowing, are we born knowing all? We growing wiser, are we just growing tall? Can you read thoughts? Can you read palms? Can you predict the future? Can you see storms coming?
I know you've deceived me, now here's a surprise.
I can see for miles and miles. I can see for miles and miles and miles.
Went too far, you would fall off. No, the earth.
born if the shape change again, everybody would have start love. The average man can't prove up most of the things that he chooses to speak of, and still run research and find out the root of the truth that you seek of. Scholars teach in universities and claim that they're smart. And
party seeks power for its own sake, not as a means but an end. Power over the human mind, and because we control the mind, reality is inside the skull, Winston. We control the laws of nature. The stars are not light years, but a few kilometers away. If we wished, we could blot them out.
Space, the final frontier.
Space may be the final frontier, but it's made in a Hollywood basement.
My question is, through your career and your writing and your acting, you've inspired so many people to enter the sciences. How do you balance science with science fiction?
They're both the same.
In case there are any conspiracy theorists out there, how would you prove to us that you're in zero gravity?
We don't have time for a meeting of the Flat Earth Society.
Mind control to Major Tom. Digitone. There is a season.